Diabetes mellitus is a chronic metabolic disease characterized by elevated levels or abnormally high levels of blood glucose or blood sugar. Most of the foods that you eat, like carbohydrates, are broken down into simple sugars known as glucose, which are then absorbed into the bloodstream, causing blood sugar level to rise. When your blood sugar goes up, it signals your pancreas to release the hormone insulin. Insulin is a hormone that regulates blood sugar levels. It is needed to move sugar from the blood into the cells, where the sugar can be used as energy. When there isn't enough insulin, or when the cells stop responding to insulin, too much blood sugar stays in your bloodstream, which over time can lead to serious health problems. Such is the case in diabetes mellitus, where your body either does not produce enough insulin, or does not utilize it as effectively as it should. There are several types of diabetes, but the three main types of diabetes are type 1, type 2, and gestational diabetes. Type 1 diabetes is an autoimmune disease, meaning your body attacks itself. The beta cells, which are insulin-producing cells in your pancreas, are damaged in this situation, and therefore, there is no insulin or not enough of it. In type 2 diabetes, there is generally enough insulin, but the cells upon which it should act are not normally sensitive to its action. Gestational diabetes develops in pregnant women who have never had diabetes. Gestational diabetes usually goes away after the baby is born, but increases your risk for type 2 diabetes later in life. It puts your child at risk of developing obesity as a child or teen, and more likely to develop type 2 diabetes later in life too. In this video, we'll mainly focus on the warning signs, or the early signs and symptoms of type 2 diabetes. These symptoms can come on slowly, and you might not know that you have type 2 diabetes until it affects your health. The first symptom we'll look at is frequent urination. Frequent urination, also known as polyuria, is one of the earliest signs of diabetes. When the glucose level in the blood is higher than normal, the kidneys cannot reabsorb all the glucose during the filtration process and must flush some of it out into the urine, leading to glucose being present in the urine. Glucose attracts water, causing more water to be excreted through urine, a process known as osmotic diuresis. Consequently, individuals with diabetes experience frequent urination to eliminate excess glucose from their body. The increased urine production causes more frequent trips to the bathroom, particularly at night. Extreme thirst, also known as polydipsia, can be one of the early warning signs of diabetes, particularly type 1 diabetes or poorly controlled type 2 diabetes. When blood sugar levels are high, the body tries to remove the excess glucose through urine, which increases urine production. This in turn exacerbates frequent urination, which can lead to dehydration because the body loses large amounts of fluids in urine. As a result, you may feel the need to drink more water to compensate for the increased fluid loss. Diabetes can cause slow healing of wounds for a number of reasons. Prolonged high blood sugar levels cause suppression of the immune system. This interferes with the body's defense ability to fight infections. The other reason is that high blood sugar levels narrow your blood vessel and causes damage to the nerves. This results in slowing of blood circulation and restricting the supply of nutrients and oxygen that are needed for proper healing of wounds. As a result, even minor cuts and wounds can take many weeks or months to heal. Poor healing of wounds increases the chances of infections. People with type 2 diabetes tend to get frequent infections more often. Your elevated blood sugar levels provide food for yeast and bacteria, providing them with the opportunity to multiply more quickly. Sugar is excreted in the urine when your blood sugar is too high for your kidneys to filter. This increases your chances of getting urinary tract infections. Candida albicans is the most common cause of fungal infection in people with diabetes. Yeast infections tend to occur more common in warm, moist parts of the skin, including the mouth, genital areas, and armpits. Excessive hunger, or polyphagia, is a common sign of diabetes. This is not the same as merely wanting to eat. Polyphagia happens when you have an appetite even after you have eaten a sufficient amount of food. Extreme hunger could be a sign of insulin resistance, which means that your body is not using insulin properly in order to help glucose enter your cells. To compensate for this, your pancreas produces more insulin, which signals your brain, therefore increasing the feelings of hunger in an attempt to get the cells the energy they need. Unintended weight loss could be another warning sign of diabetes. When the cells in the body do not receive enough glucose for energy, as in the case of type 2 diabetes, the body turns to fat storage that is burnt for generation of energy. Another reason for this is that people with uncontrolled type 2 diabetes tend to lose a lot of glucose in urine. All this combined with dehydration results in a significant loss of weight, even while you're eating more and more to satisfy your hunger. This is another reason why persons with diabetes often feel hungry all of the time, no matter how recently they ate. Tingling, numbness, or pain in the hands or feet is another warning sign of type 2 diabetes. This is a sign of nerve damage or diabetic neuropathy. It is a condition that usually takes a long time to manifest. It is more likely to happen after years of diabetes, but it can also be a first warning for some people. If a person does not seek treatment for their diabetes, it might worsen over time and lead to more serious complications. Blurred vision usually occurs early in uncontrolled diabetes. When blood sugar levels shift quickly from low to high or high to low, and the eye muscles haven't yet adapted, blurred vision might develop. High blood sugar can make you have trouble focusing. The lens loses some of its ability to bend in a high sugar environment, and the eye muscles have to work harder to focus. Long-term high blood sugar levels put you at risk for more serious complications like diabetic retinopathy, which can lead to blindness. Darkened skin patches can be a sign or symptom associated with type 2 diabetes. This condition is known as acanthosis nigricans. Acanthosis nigricans is characterized by the presence of thick, dark, and velvety patches of skin, typically in the folds and creases of the body, such as the neck, armpits, groin, and sometimes the elbows and knees. The darkened skin patches in acanthosis nigricans occur due to an increase in insulin levels in the blood. Insulin resistance, which is a hallmark of type 2 diabetes, leads to higher insulin levels as the body tries to compensate for the decreased effectiveness of insulin. The exact mechanisms behind acanthosis nigricans are not fully understood, but it is believed that insulin stimulates the growth of skin cells and the production of melanin, resulting in the darkened appearance. In the case of type 2 diabetes, fatigue and weakness can occur due to several reasons, one of which is high blood sugar level. In diabetes, the body may struggle to effectively use insulin or produce enough insulin to regulate blood sugar level. As a result, glucose remains in the bloodstream, depriving the cells of energy and leading to fatigue and weakness. Inadequate management of blood sugar levels in individuals with diabetes can lead to fluctuations in energy levels. People with type 2 diabetes may have challenges maintaining a balanced diet. Uncontrolled blood sugar levels can affect the body's ability to properly utilize nutrients, which can lead to fatigue and weakness. Being aware of the warning signs and symptoms of type 2 diabetes is crucial for early detection and effective management. If you or someone you know is experiencing any of the symptoms discussed in this video, we strongly encourage you to seek medical advice and get tested for diabetes. Don't hesitate to reach out to healthcare professionals who can guide you on the right path to diagnosis and treatment. Remember, managing type 2 diabetes involves a combination of lifestyle changes, medication, and regular monitoring of blood sugar levels. By taking proactive steps towards a healthier lifestyle, individuals with type 2 diabetes can greatly reduce the risk of developing complications, improve overall health, and lead fulfilling and productive lives. Thank you for watching. We hope that this information has been valuable to you and has shed light on the importance of recognizing these early indicators of type 2 diabetes. If you found this video helpful, don't forget to give it a thumbs up, subscribe to our channel for more informative content, and hit the notification bell to stay updated on future videos. Also, feel free to share this video with friends and family who might benefit from this knowledge.